The big game is fast approaching, but wait, you still haven't got your tickets. You've spent hours searching, but you're still confused about ticket prices. Time to stop searching. Visit ticketcompare.com. We compare ticket prices for all the popular leagues and tournaments for you. We work only with the most trustworthy sites, so you can have peace of mind when buying your tickets. Compare prices, buy tickets, get to the game. Ticketcompare.com. Buying tickets made simple.
Good afternoon.
Okay, let's get things started. Ian, are you around? Yeah, over to you.
I'll tell you.
Hey.
In previous rounds of this competition, you've given opportunities to the likes of the Caballero, to Charlie Lissonde, Kennedy, Vichy Batshuayi. Is that something that you will continue?
Yeah, I'll continue in this way. Yeah, for sure. I'll continue in this way. It's right to continue the opportunity, to continue to give the chance for the players who showed me that they deserve to have this opportunity.
It's the quarterfinals. Is this where the competition begins to get serious?
But every competition, I think, is serious, and I think our task is to try to win the game, to try to reach the semifinal. But at the same time, I think that it's right in this competition to give the opportunity for to the players that they are not playing with the regularity. And for me, it's very important to pay great attention to the performance in this game. And yeah, I think it's right to continue in this way with my players. Also because it's very difficult to ask to your players to play every game. But for example, Conte played 10 games in a row. But when you do this, it means that you take great risk. For injuries, for a lot of things.
Do you sense there is a risk as well, though, in making lots of changes?
But we played against Everton, and we did this. I repeat, against Everton, we won the game, and we went through to the next round. I hope tomorrow as well, but as you know very well, Bournemouth is a really good team, and we must be prepared to suffer. We must be prepared to fight a lot to go through to the next round.
Kennedy has played in both of the previous rounds. Obviously, he had his difficulties in the summer. How has he applied himself in training this season?
But Kennedy tried to give everything during the training, and during these 5 months, and the behaviors, the commitment was perfect, and I think that it's right for this reason to give him the opportunity, the chance to play an important game. And I repeat, I have to trust to my players, and I think that also, not only with the words, but with the facts, and to show that I trust in my players, and I want to give them a big opportunity in a big game to show me that they deserve to play.
Does he train with the first team every day? And has he trained with the first team squad?
But who, Kennedy?
Kennedy, yes.
Yeah. When he's not injured, for sure, and he stay with us every day with the first team. Yeah, but in the period when he was injured and he was in department, medical department.
Has he been forgiven for what happened in China in the summer?
Yeah, but this is the past. This is the past, and it happened, and I stopped. But If you remember very well, when we came back from China and Kennedy started to have training session with us, then I repeat, I have to make decision, technical decision, and it's only this. I have to take technical to make a technical decision in every game, and in this case, I think that he deserves to have this opportunity to play and to show that he deserves to play for Chelsea.
In terms of the rest of your squad, I mean, Marcos Alonso is suspended. Do you have any other concerns?
No, but there is a Musonda. Musonda has a little problem, muscular problem in his groin, but not not from today, but also before the game against against Southampton, yeah, and he's out. And then I think that. No other injury worries.
Alvaro Morata, you said he had a bit of a problem ahead of the Southampton match. He did come on. Is he okay?
Yeah, he's okay. And he had this problem in his back before the game against West Ham. And then he struggled a lot with this this problem. But now I think that he's working very well. He's finding the best form and. Yeah, but tomorrow I want to give an opportunity and a chance to play Batshuayi.
It wouldn't be a Chelsea press conference if I didn't ask you something about David Luiz. I know how much you like talking about him. Listen, he's in the news every day.
Yeah.
He's going here, he's going there, he's going to Manchester United, Arsenal are interested, maybe Newcastle. Where do you think all this information is coming from?
I don't read, and I saw the problem. I don't read, and I don't have some information about this topic. I repeat, I'm a person very realistic. I like to tell the truth, and I answered you 3 days before during the press conference about him. I think that also I don't want to annoy you. With the same reply.
But why do you think there's so much talk, speculation?
But I repeat, I don't read it. I don't listen this. I don't hear anything about this. What I think, I don't read about my speculation and for the other. Yeah.
Listen, tell me about Bournemouth. They lost 4-0 to Liverpool at the weekend. Eddie Howe says they are in a relegation battle. How do you see Bournemouth?
But for sure, last game was a bad game, a bad defeat. When you lose 4-0 at home, it's not simple. It's not simple. Yeah. For this reason, we must pay great attention tomorrow because Bournemouth wants to take a revenge, no? A revenge, and to try to create problems. For sure, Bournemouth wants to go through to the next round, like us. And for this reason, we must be focused. And I think we have prepared the game very well under different aspects, tactical aspect, under mentality, under all aspects. Now we have to play. We have to play and to try to go to the next round.
Okay, last one, Ian, because we've got to move on.
Away from football, not to do with football. What do you want for Christmas? Less than a week away.
I think that I spend my time with my family, with my parents, with my brothers, the families of my brothers. Yeah, I think that Christmas is a period that you have to enjoy with your family, and I like to do this. Nothing was special, But to stay together, I think that is the best gift for me.
Have you done all your shopping yet? Have you got your wife's present?
As you know very well, it's very difficult to find time for the gift. I think that I'll try to find a bit of time to make a gift for my wife and my daughter, for sure, and also for my parents, for my brothers. Yeah, but in this case, I'll ask help to my wife.
Okay, Matt.
Just to clarify, is David out of the game tomorrow, David Luiz?
Yeah, but he's out, but he's not available. But
yeah, it's just you said Musonda was the only injury that
just. Yeah, but because David Luiz is an injury very old. Yeah. Very old, and now I think is maybe 3 weeks.
Yeah.
3 weeks.
Okay.
Yeah, and
how much importance do you place on the first silverware of the season? Could winning the League Cup, could that help momentum for the rest of the season?
I think that we have to play and to try to to put all ourselves in every competition. I think every competition is important for us, for my players. But we want to play, want to try to win. We want to try to the next round. Then I repeat, this cup is a good opportunity for me, maybe for me and to. To give the chance, to give the opportunity for the players that in this moment they are not playing with regularity, for the players that they are struggling to find the best form after an injuries, drink water for example, and for Bashuai it was the same, and for Kennedy it was the same, and but. I repeat, and every competition is important for us, but at the same time, we have to try to find the right balance, because the season is very tough, and I want to involve all my players in all competitions.
Can a good performance tomorrow? Can a player putting in a good performance come into your first team? Can they do enough to get into your first team by playing well tomorrow? Kennedy plays really well tomorrow.
Yeah.
Could he take Marcus Alonso's place in your best team?
Yeah, but this is normal. This is normal. I hope to have this type of problem. As you know very well, I don't like before to take a decision. From the start 11, how to if a player play or not, I don't look the last part of the body that I look is the head. Understand? You don't play because I see that you are this player, you have big name, and this is not my idea of football. This is not my behaviors, and I like to make the best decision for what I see. During the training session or during the game. This is only, if you deserve to play, you play. And don't forget that Christensen is playing, only 21 years old. Sometimes you forget, no? You ask me, but why in Chelsea doesn't play the young player? Then I put the young player now. Christensen is playing and is showing to deserve to play. And he's playing in a fantastic way. I think that this guy has a fantastic prospect for the present and for the future.
Okay, last one. We've got to just do one more. I think Liam was last.
Antonio, speaking of young players, there have been suggestions that cabinet players Callum Hudson-Odoi and Dijon Sterling have been training in the first team squad. Is there a chance that they could be involved tomorrow, particularly maybe Sterling, given that Alonso is suspended?
Yeah, but I think could be. could be. And, why not? Why not? I think these players are the future for Chelsea. And Sterling is a really good player, although he won the World Cup. And Ampadu played the last game against Everton. Maybe he could start also tomorrow. Yeah, I think that I must consider the young players if they deserve to have this chance. I think that Sterling a lot of time is working with us in this season. Ampadu is always every day with the first team. And Odoi is another player that deserves to have a chance to show that he can play for this team for 10 years, for 15 years.
Okay, cameras off, please. Let's move.